Friends, here we are going to discuss about what are the rules to create a pattern such that you can use that pattern in your regular expressions. See, already we know simply what is a regex or regular expression. See, the regex is a procedure in any language to look for a specified pattern in a given text. Now, if you want to work with the regular expressions using your Python, then you have to use a module called RE. And that is the default module. So if you want to work with RE in your scripts, you have to import that, simply import RE. Now in this RE module, you're having different types of operations. Now I'm going to show you some of them, like search, match, find iter, find all, substitute, split, compile, right? And see, as of now, we are at very beginning stage to work with your regular expressions. That's why I'm going to show you simple syntaxes for your search, match, find iter and find all. See, this is one regular expression and here we are using search operation. Now the purpose of search operation from your regular expression is different. Same way, the match is different, find iter is different, find all is different. But whatever it may be, all these operations are going to use a called pattern. Now before going to work with your regular expressions operations, first of all, we should be good with the pattern. I mean, how to create a pattern or what are the rules to create your pattern, right? Once if you are good with pattern, then you can very easily use your required operation from your regex or RE module. So first I'm showing you very simple examples for your pattern. And already we know that, guys, what is a pattern? Pattern is simply a sequence of characters which represent multiple strings. Now see that I am taking one of the pattern called Python inside of a quotation. First of all, this is a string, your pattern, but this is normally a string. But whenever if you use this string inside of your regular expressions, then it is going to become a pattern. Now, generally I am saying that pattern is going to represent multiple strings, but of course, sometimes your pattern is also going to represent only one string, no problem. But if you use your string inside of regular expressions, then this is going to become a pattern. Now this pattern is going to represent only one string. But if I take this pattern Python in square brackets 2 and 3, first of all, this is a string. Normally this is a string, but if you use this string inside of your regular expressions, now it is going to become a pattern. Now if it is a pattern, it is going to represent two strings, Python 2 and Python 3. That's it. Now here we have to know how the square brackets are going to work here. See, based on square brackets, now this entire string is going to represent two strings. That's why this is called a pattern. Now we have to learn this type of rules to create a pattern. Anyway, we will see them one by one, step by step. And guys, sometimes for your pattern, you can also use OR. That is called raw string. But there is some purpose for that. We'll discuss that in your advanced level of your regular expressions. Now guys, just to get idea on how to create a pattern or to understanding the rules to create your pattern, I'm going to take one of the operation from your regular expressions, that is called find all, because compared to all, this find all is very easy. So I'm going to take this operation just to give the clarity on or to create rules for your patterns. Then later we will work with all operations. See, once if you are good with pattern, then we can work with any operation from your regular expressions. Right? Fine. Now see that. Find all. This is one of the operation from your regular expression. Now, how to use that find all? Simply, you have to import your RE module inside of your scripts on your command line. Then re.findAll pattern text. So this is your given text. In this text, you are going to search for something, search for some string that we are going to use that we are going to find by using find all operation from your RE. So finally, whatever you are going to get, that I am printing. That's it. Right? See that, just to give simple idea, I'm going to write a simple Python script. Let me save this. Of course, you can practice this in your on your command line as well. So practice for regex.py. See, first of all, we are going to work with regular expressions in your Python. So we need to import RE and make sure that this is a default module. you no need to install your RE module. By default, it is there with your Python. Now, first of all, let me take my string, or let me say simply text. You can take anything. This is just a variable. So this is a Python and it is easy to learn. That's it. This is my string. Now my intention is I want to search a string called is in a given text. See that what I am doing is simply I'm going to create my pattern. Pattern is nothing but what is your required string? What is the required string you want to search in a given text? That is a pattern. So I want to search with only is. Now let me simply print re dot find all your pattern in a given text. So guys, these are the variables. Directly, if you want to write your pattern here and your text here, you can write it. I will show you that as well. Now let me run this and see the output. See, in your entire text, in how many places is there? See, guys, be clear, we are not going to work with the word. Word means before your starting letter of a word, you should have some space. After ending letter of your word, you should have some space. Then that is a word. But as of now, you are not going to work with a word. We are going to work with a string. See, is there with the combination of this word, but we are looking just simply is a string. So here is there. Here is there, here is there. So all those is you are getting. See what I am saying is, yeah, while working with your regular expressions, directly you can write your pattern here and your text here. See, I'm going to write this thing. But instead of writing, just I stored in some variables and now I am working with variables. There is no change, right? Anyway, this is not a good practice. First store your text into some variable and your pattern into some variable, then use that variables. Fine. Now how it is going to work? Very simple. What is your pattern? Is. So two letters string you are searching. What your Python will do from your given text, it will take first two characters. Then is this are these two characters are equals to these two characters? No, that's why it will skip that part. Then it will take second character and third character, HI. Are they equals to is? No. Then it is going to skip. Then third and fourth it will take. Yes, is and is. Now it is going to match, you are going to get. So likewise, it is going to compare in your entire text. Wherever there is a match for is, those strings you are going to get. Be clear, not a word. Just simply you are going to match for a string. Even word is also a string. See, here is word, but here is not a word. That is the combination of with some other word, but we are not looking for a word. We are looking for a string. That's it. Now, can you tell me very simple logic here? That is, how many times is there in a given text? How many times is there in a given text? See, if you observe the operation result, find all operation result is a list, no? We know the length we can find for a list by using length operation, so that you can conclude that there are three is strings are there in a given text. It's very, very important one. That's fine. So first let me write once again, print re dot find all your pattern given text. Fine. Now my intention is, actually, the basic purpose of your regular expression is at a time, if you want to search multiple strings, then we are going to work with regular expressions. Now I want to print from my given text wherever is there. I mean, is string and it string. All those things I want to print. See, my intention, be clear. I want to search for is and it in a given text. So if is there, it has to print. If it is there, it has to print. Suppose if is there multiple times, all times it has to print. If it is there multiple times, all its it has to print. But now you have to understand that this year you are having two strings, but from this you need to make a pattern. such that that pattern has to represent these two strings, so that by using that pattern you can search in a given string for these two strings. See, if you observe, first character is common, no? That's why I can take simply I. Then second character, it may be S or T. So whenever there is a possibility of this one or that one, then just simply write square brackets inside of that. Just write ST or TS, no problem, both are same. Right, now see that what I am doing is, instead of is, first character is I, but second character may be S or may be T. Now see the result. Is, it is. Yes, you are getting. But you don't need to follow order here. I mean, first S, second T. No, not like that. You can also write TS also, no problem. See that. Now you are looking for a string which consists of two characters, first of all. And that string, two character string, maybe is or maybe it. Now you are going to search for two strings with length of two. That means two characters in each string. Those strings are it and is in a given text. Now, if they are in a given text, then your find all is going to find them. Let's say, suppose I am trying to find. Let me comment this. I want to find like my pattern equals to simply X. Do you have X in your given text? No, that's why you're getting empty. Right? Do you have A? Yes, how many times A is there? That many number of times you are getting. Here A is there, be clear. Very, very important. Here A is there, here A is there, here A is there. So wherever you have A, that all A's you are getting here. So if you go with advanced operations like search, find iter, then you are going to get the index position as well. What is the index of first matching character, first matching string and second matching string? We will see that in advanced level. So for time being, we have to understand how to create a pattern. Now here I'm going to show you the simple rules to create your pattern. But this is just first level rules, basic rules. So we will see advanced level rules in next video. Fine. The very first thing is, suppose I want to match A with A, then directly you have to write A. There is no any other option. I mean, suppose here I have written A, right? So you are going to match A with A, then you are getting. Suppose I want to match with some number. If number is there, 9, that to 9. If that 9 number is there in a given string, then given string means text, guys. In this text variable, if you have a 9, then this Python will find that. But as of now, you don't have any 9 number in a given text. That's why it is not finding. So simple rule is, if you want to match with any particular character with a particular character, then you need to directly write your pattern as that character only. Let's say somewhere I'm having at the rate. Now I want to search how many times at the rate is there in a given text. See that? One time. Let me write somewhere once again this at the rate. Now let me rerun your code and see the result. In two places you have at the rate. Now those two at the rates you are getting. Fine. Now, if you want to match any character with particular character, then you have to write that character itself. That is, anyway, we know that generally. Second rule. See, just now we have seen that if I write something like TS or ST, what is the meaning for this? It is going to look for either T or for S. But same way, if I write ABC, now it is going to look for either A or B or C in a given text. Let me show you that so that you can understand. Suppose I am writing, as of now, my pattern is at the rate. Now your find all is going to match or look in a given text only for at the rate. Now what I am doing is, if I write something like at the rate A, what is the meaning for this? You are going to look for a string which consists of at the rate and A immediately side by side at the rate and A. Do you have anywhere in a given text? No, nowhere we have at the rate and A immediately in a given text. Now see the result, empty. But I want to look either for at the rate or for A or for S. You can write any number of characters inside of square brackets. Now the meaning is, assume that your Python is going to search for at the rate also for A and also for S. Now see the result. How many times S are there? That many times you are going to get S. How many times A is there? That many times A you are getting. How many times at the rate is there? You are getting. Now, first of all, you are looking for only one character string in a given string. That character may be at the rate, may be A or may be S. So all these three are there some number of times. You are going to get all of them that many number of times. Right? Fine. Now see here. So sometimes I want to just assume that I want to look for either A or B or C or D or E or F. So what is the meaning of if you write any characters inside of a square bracket means? First of all, this entire thing is one character. But that character may be A or maybe B or maybe C, D, likewise. So I can write in this way if I want to look for either A or B or C or D or E or F. But all these are sequence characters, right? A to F. So instead of writing in this way, there is a shortcut for this. You can also write simply A to F. Now the meaning for this is you are going to look for one character string, but that character may be A or maybe B or up to F. That's it. Now assume that something like this. I want to search a string. Let's say A, B, C, D, either A or B or C or D or some H, I, J, K, L or X, Y, Z. No spaces, guys. Just assume that I have written A, B, C, D, H, I, J, K, L and X, Y, Z. Now, what is the first of all meaning for this? If you write anything inside of a square brackets, it is going to look for one character string, but that character may be A or maybe B, something like that from this group. But if you observe, first four characters are sequence. Next five characters are also in sequence. Next three characters are also sequence. In that case, you can also write shortcut as A to D. Now, by default, A to D means A, B, C, D, then H hyphen L. The meaning for this is H, I, J, K, L, then X hyphen Z. Now the meaning for this is X, Y, Z. Just for this shortcut, this is. Right? Now, see that. Let me take a given text. So my intention is, let me comment this code as of now. Actually, my intention is just I want to look for either A or B or C or D. Let me take it. So my pattern, I want to look for only for either A or B or C or D. Whenever if you want to look for either A or B or C or D, then you have to write your characters inside of a square brackets. Now let me print. Your operation is from RE find all. From your pattern, your given text. Now see the result. A, B, C, D. C is not there nowhere and B also not there, but A and D is there. That's why you are getting that. A, D, A. Right? But the same thing I can also write A to D. See the result. First, two A's, one D, two A's. Now see the result. I'm going to rerun by changing my pattern. Same thing you're getting. So this is exactly equals to A, B, C, D. See, sometimes you're going to look for any character, suppose A to Z. No need to write A, B, C, D, E, F, G up to Z. Simply A to Z, you can write A hyphen Z in square brackets. That's it. So this is one of the rule. Then, so that's what I am giving here. So this is already we discussed. Suppose if you have A, B, C, D, some H, I, J, K and X, Y, Z, you can also write shortcut in this way. Now, let me take small w slash w matches any single character or digit or underscore. See that. See guys, if I write simply pattern as A is going to match with only A. Your find all is going to look for this A in a given text for A only. But if you write instead of A, if I write some special symbol called slash W, now the meaning for this is any alphabet from A to Z or capital A to Z, then number 0 to 9 or maybe underscore also. See, suppose if we have a text called ABC and if I write a pattern A, now if I look into this, A is going to get only one time. But if I write in place of A slash W, A is also a slash W, or B also comes under slash W, C also comes under slash W. Now you're going to get three characters because slash W means any alphabet and number and one underscore as well. Let me show you this on your script. See, my intention is, let me comment this code. Guys, be clear. I'm going to take my pattern as regular, I'm not taking raw string as of now, but we have to take it. I will tell you when you have to take or fine. Now what I'm doing is simply I'm writing slash W. Now see the result. If I do print your re dot find all your pattern in a given text, see the result. You're going to get all matching things except space. Are we getting space matching? See, after this is, between this and is, we have a space. Are we getting a space anywhere here? No, because space not comes under slash small w. That's why you're not getting the matching for that. And at the rate not comes under your slash w. That's why this is not a match for your slash w. That's why you're not getting that. Let me write somewhere hyphen. And let me write somewhere underscore. Now see the result. You are getting underscore between O and L. There is a underscore, but between O and underscore, you have a space. That space is not a match. You are not getting that. And hyphen is not comes under this slash W, but underscore comes under slash W. That's why you are getting here. Now I am looking for two letter string or two character string. If I write slash W, the meaning for that is just assumption. Slash W means A to Z small letters and A to Z capital letters and number 0 to 9 and underscore. Now, if I write two slash W's, the meaning for that is it may be AA, AB, AC, likewise A to Z and BA, BB, BC, likewise, or maybe A0, A1, A2, up to A9 or A underscore, right? B underscore. C underscore, likewise, you're going to get number of combinations. Among all those combinations, whatever the matching is there in a given string, you're going to get them. See, if I write slash W slash W, the meaning for that is you're going to look for a string which consists of two characters. Now, if I run this, see, TH is also one match for this. First, let me run this and see the output so that you can understand. See that? TH, two letter string, yes, match. That's why you're getting that. Is, yes, you are getting. Then is, your, in between you have a space, right? Space is not comes under your slash W. That's why you are not getting that. Is, yes, you are getting. See, A is only one single character. Before A and after A, you have a space. So combination with A, you don't have any valid character which comes under slash W. In case if space comes under slash W, you're going to get a space also, but space not comes under slash W matching. That's why for A, you don't have any combination to get two character string. That's why this is not going to match for your pattern. Right? And one more thing, see that last LE, suppose two character string, AR, two character string. But for N, you don't have again any matching to get a two character string. After N, suppose if you have any character, let's say A. Now, if I run this, see the last thing. You're getting AR. After AR, now I added here A letter, A character. Now, if I rerun, you're going to get NA also. Not only A, you can take underscore also. Because underscore also comes under slash W, you're going to get match by using these two characters combination. Now let me write three character matching. Guys, now the meaning for this is you are going to look for a string which consists of three characters. But what are those three characters? We know slash w means any character a to z, small or capital, 0 to 9 and underscore. Only from these three groups, it is going to look for three character string. Now let me run this and see the result. THI, three letter character. Yes, you are getting. But for yes, after that you have a space. So space not comes under slash w. That's why there is no possibility for this yes to make three letter character. Then it is going to skip. Then for is, you have only two characters, but you don't have any three characters string. Because if you want to get a three character string, here we have a space. But space is not comes under slash w. That's why you are not getting a part for this. Same way for a, you don't have any three character string. But Python, PYT, three characters, valid characters. HYN, three characters. That's why you are getting that. AND, three characters. For it, you don't have any valid three characters. That's why you are not getting. Is, yes, EAS, three characters. But for Y, we don't have any three character string combination. That's why this is not a part. Likewise, you are getting. I hope you are good with this. Now let me go with the capital W. Matches any character not part of slash W. See, whatever you have in this small w, other than that, all are going to comes under capital W. See that. Now let me comment this. First, let me take my pattern as small w only and see the result first. Print re dot find all. Guys, you can get clarity by doing practice. Please do same thing once. I mean, whatever we done here, same thing, you just practice once and try to understand how you're going to get your output. Now let me run this and see the output. But if I make it as a capital W, see T and H, I, S, whatever you are getting here, no, these are not the part of capital W. They are part of small w. That's why if I write capital W, see what you are going to get. You are going to get spaces at the rate and hyphen. Because these are not the part of your capital small w. It is going to look for a character which is not there in this group, small w group. Space is the match for capital W. At the rate is the match for capital W. See how many spaces are there, all those spaces you are going to get here. So that is the use of capital W. Simply the members which are there in this, other than that, remaining all are comes under capital W. Very, very important. Then slash D matches a decimal digit 0 to 9, any number. See, anyway, by default, small w means it also include your numbers. But along with numbers, slash w includes alphabet and underscore. But I want to match with only numbers. Let's say I have somewhere, let me write Python 3. Python 3, and let's say somewhere, just for here I am writing Python 2, and somewhere I am writing some number, let's say 4. Okay, now what I am doing is I am going to take a pattern as some slash d. You know what is meant by slash d? Any number 0 to 9. See, I am going to take pattern as slash d, and let me print it re dot find all, sorry, find all your pattern in a given text. So wherever number is there, because you are looking for only a character which consists of only one digit, a string which consists of only one character, that is a digit. Now see the result, 243. Yes, we have somewhere 243, you are getting that. Now my intention is Python with some number. So before slash D, I should have a word called Python. After that, any number, maybe 2 or 3. Now if I run this, you are going to get Python after that number is there. No, that now this is the match for this pattern. At the same time, Python 3 is also match for slash d. Suppose if I write only Python 2, you are going to get only Python 3 2, because directly you are mentioning match 2 with 2, Python 2 with Python 2. But I want to match with Python slash d, means the meaning for this, it is going to represent Python 0, Python 1, Python 2, Python 3, up to Python 9. But among all those, whatever the strings are there in a given text, those strings only it is going to match. That's it. Right? Now let's say instead of this pattern, I want to look for a string which consists of two digits. Do we have anything in this? No. So sequentially, I mean immediately two digits, nowhere we are having. That's why you are not getting that. Let's say I want to write here 45 something. Now you are getting that because two digits are there. You are looking for /d/d means a string which consists of two digits. Yes, you are getting. Now, so in this basic rules, let me go with the last one, dot. Very, very important one, at the same time confusion one. Very useful in your real time, dot. Dot matches any single character except new line character. See, if you take /w, other than these members, all are comes under /W. But if you go with dot, all valid characters which are there in your keyboard or which are there in your computer language, all are going to match with your dot except a new line. See that? Let me comment these things first. Guys, these are very basic rules to create your patterns. We have advanced levels as well. We will see them in our next video. So now my intention is I'm taking a pattern as dot means match with any character. Now see that what you are going to get, your pattern comma text, all are going to get. See that we're going to get each and every character which is there in a given text. Anyway, we don't have any /n, I mean new line in our given text. Except that dot is going to match all things. Now, if you observe THIS, after that space is there in a given text. Yes, that space is also matching for dot. Dot means anything simply other than /n. Now, I want to match any two characters. Then write two dots. Now see the result. I want to match for three dots. I mean any three characters, any three symbols which are there in your computer language. See that? 3, 3 you are going to get. Now my intention is I want to match dot with dot only. Dot, generally dot means in your pattern, dot means for any matching except new line. But I want to match dot with dot. Let's say in a given text somewhere I have dot, Python 2 dot. Now if I run this, what you are getting? See, now you are also going to get somewhere dot also. You are looking for three digits string. Yes, sorry, three character string. Yes, you are getting n2 dot. But along with the dot, you are also getting some other strings. No, but I don't want to get them. I want to get exactly dot with dot only. I want to match my dot with dot. See, if you remember, if you want to match A with A, let's say this is your text ABC. This is your text and you want to write a pattern. How you can write a pattern if you want to match A with A? A only you are writing. Now in my text somewhere I have dot, but I want to match dot with dot. Simply if I write dot, dot is going to match with any character. But I want to match this dot only. At that time you have to escape your special purpose of your dot by placing slash symbol. Let me run this. /dot. Now see the result. Let me write some other ways, some in other places dot. See that? That's it. But if I remove this slash, now you are going to get all characters which are going to match for your dot. By simply dot means anything. That's it. Except new line. So it's very, very important, guys. If you want to match dot with dot, you have to use in your pattern /dot. Very, very useful example I'm going to give. In your real time, let's say you have a text in this way. This is my IP of a DB server. Let's just assume that some 255 dot let's say 100, 102. Of course, as of now, I'm taking in my IP in all places 3 digits. But see, you may have sometimes here only 2 digits or 1 digit, right? But as of now, based on our rules, if I go with this example, you can understand. Later we will see in our advanced level, if you have only 1 digit here, how to match everything, we will see. Now I am going to tell you one important thing from your real time. See, you are going to run some script or some information is there somewhere in your text file and you are going to read that, but you don't know where your IP is there. Assume that you are getting some output somewhere. In that output, you have IP, but you don't know where exactly your IP is there. Where exactly your IP is there, but I want to fetch only my IP. How you can write a pattern? See, I can write a pattern, any variable, just take any variable. I am taking simply now pattern or my pattern or X equals to also you can take. See, as of now, I'm assuming that in my IP, in all places, 3 digits number is there. That's why /D/D/D means you are looking for 3 digit string in a given text. But first, let me run this so that you can understand. What happened? Yeah, sorry, I have written at the end one more extra slash. Fine. Now see that. Find all your pattern, your text. See the output. Okay, let me write 3 digits. Now see the output. 255, 100, 102, 103. You are getting separately, but this entire thing is one IP. I want to get as a only one value, not like this. Then what I have to do? I want to write a pattern such that it is going to match with this thing. I don't know exact number what is there, but I know in each and every position there are 3 digits. Then 3/D/D's, then /D/D/D/D/D/D/D. Now see the output. It's working perfectly, right? It's working perfectly. Now see the magic. Let's say here instead of /D, what I am doing is /W I am writing. Just assume that, because under /W you're also going to get a digit, right? Now see the result, what you are getting. You are getting, now I am writing THIS something in this way. I am writing. Now see the result, what you are getting. Nowhere you have dot here. No, then why it is matching with your given pattern? Because dot means anything, but I want to match dot with dot only. I want to match dot with dot only. Otherwise, let me take in terms of numbers only so that you will get idea. Let's say 1, 2, 3, one extra number. Let me write some numbers. Some number. This is not IP, right? But I'm writing some number. Now let me write instead of this thing. Guys, be clear why I'm giving this. Means in your real time, you're going to get sometimes confusion. For that, I'm giving some clarity here to use your /D. Now if I run this, see the output. This is IP, but this is not a IP, right? Our intention is 3 digits, then dot, 3 digits, then dot, 3 digits, then dot, 3 digits. In this way, if I have any string in a given text, that only I want to fetch. Yes, I'm fetching that. Along with that, why I'm getting this? See, now you are not matching dot with dot. If you want to match this dot with this dot, you don't write dot, you have to write /dot. Simply if I write dot, dot means any digit, any character. That's why, see, /D/D, this is going to match for first 3 digits. Then dot means anything, no? Now this is also going to match. Again, 3 digits, yes, 3 digits. Then dot means anything, 5 is also going to match for dot. But our intention is not for this type of numbers. Some 3 digits, then dot. Some 3 digits, then dot. Then some 3 digits, dot. Likewise. That's why if you want to match with dot, you have to use slash dot. That's it. Now see the result. So that's why there is a small difference between dot and slash dot. You need to understand that clearly. Simple thing. I want to match dot with the dot only. Then you have to write slash dot. That's it. Okay. Okay, guys, don't get confused. We are going to practice with a number of examples so that you will get good idea about your regular expressions. So as of now, these are the simple rules to create your pattern. In next video, we'll discuss about advanced level rules to create your pattern. Okay, thank you for watching this video.